Gun crime is just one of the dangers facing the men and women on the thin blue line. But sometimes the challenge is closer to home. Stress-related illnesses are becoming a major issue for the police force. So, if they're protecting us, who is protecting them?
Car wrecks, child mistreatment, murders, stabbing, shootings.
As far as jobs go, it's the front line for human emotions. From devastation to anxiety and rage, and sometimes the memories won't go away.
I'd be ill probably 3 to 5 times a week.
Troy McAway is a very different person to the one who stepped out of the Goulburn Academy, the bright-eyed constable worn down by long hours, public abuse and a colleague attempting suicide.
The nights before going to work, I'd be up, I'd go to bed, and within about an hour of going to bed, I'd be up basically throwing up and being ill.
He believes the culture within the police force aggravates the problem.
They end up breaking because you don't want to admit that there is an issue.
And the issue is growing. Over the past 5 years, stress claims have rocketed to 578. That's a 67% increase. The cost in work cover payouts over the same period tops $180 million.
And that doesn't include the reports entered for verbal and physical assault. Last year, they came from 1,500 officers. That's 1 in 10.
Stress is the fastest growing claim.
And on that farm they had some pigs. E-I-E-I-O.
Our members are suffering some of the most severe psychological conditions that there are. Post-traumatic stress disorder, severe depression. These are rendering them unfit for work and in many cases tragically unfit to operate as a human being.
Look, those numbers always worry us, but what we are very, very focused on is ensuring that we get a number of programs out there to try and help our police get through those situations and get them back to work as quickly as possible.
Denham Hitchcock, 9 News.